You soon arrive at your destination. The field looks empty in the twilight of the dawn. Cold wind seems to penetrate you to the bone. When you step onto the plowed field, you sense a familiar shiver. This field harbors evil spirits. You find a poorly hidden bundle of old wheat ears. It's a Khaldun's Zalom. The stems are tied in a knot and dusted with ashes and salt. Fresh grave soil, eggshells, and steamed grains are laid around it. You draw a circle. You feel that demons are not far off.
Wind, oh wind of the seven brothers, the oldest one. Do not blow from the rotten corner. Do not bring rain from the west. But blow us warmth. Render good service to our people. Bring forth pleasant rain. Joy to plowmen. Glory to you, fierce one.
You finish reciting the Zagavar, and for a moment, silence falls. Suddenly, a creaky voice from behind startles you.
You sure are a strange creature. First you curse it, then you bless it right after.
By you, do you mean us, Khaldun's?
Ha! Humans. Always on the border between worlds. And that is why you always lose. But who am I to complain? My name is Andriko. And you, I've heard about you. You're the new witch, Vasilisa.
So is it you who spoils the field, sending dry winds?
Spoil? You use the wrong word. I am helping the peasants, and I am a master at this. I mean, surely you understand the business for their own good, don't you?
What possible good can broken rye do?
Oh, you disappoint me. All right, here's the thing. The peasants will have a bad harvest this year. That is so. But it will make them search for new, better ways to grow wheat. So when the real famine comes, people will be ready. Their newly gained skills will help them overcome the true hardships. As you can see, I am a visionary! Well, now, shall we go our separate ways?
Don't be a glib with me. Tell me. It's not by chance that I came across this Zalom.
You don't say. Perhaps you know who's to blame.
The Zalom caused this chort to appear. Who left these weeders? Who summoned this chort? You were sent here by another Khaldun, weren't you?
Ha! Right. You know, I'm starting to like you. I could even tell you who the Cauldron is who sent me. If you weren't so careful, this alarm had already been enchanted when I arrived. Want to make a deal? Let me finish what I started. I'll send some dry winds, and after that, I'll be your servant. The famine will cause death in heaps.
I have all the charts I need. Don't be a glib with me. Tell me. Enough talking. I'll definitely banish you from this field.
Have got in my way.
And yet I have. Deal with it.
Thank you.
So, the name of the girl will be... a fitting name. You did the right thing sorting out that demon. Won't spoil any good crops anymore. The only thing left to do is visit the spinner. Vasilisa and I are going to see the spinner. There's nothing for you to do there, Kolya. Understand?
Sure, dude.
And one more thing. Don't say anything about the Banya or the Bride. The spinner can't stand demons, though she looks like one herself. Got it?
Who is the spinner?
A woman of sorts. Her name is Kapitalina Ivanovna, but everyone calls her the spinner behind her back. She's quite knowledgeable. You don't want to mess with her. That's why I am coming with you. Don't go running your mouth. Speak nothing of the book. Got it?
What should I say to get the belt?
Good question, Vasilisa. Keep your ears open when you speak to her. Remember, do not mention demons. She does not like them. And you might as well disregard the fact that we needed the belt for a changeling girl. Now, if you show you are of knowledge, that would be good indeed. If she doesn't like you, or should you let anything slip, the cost will be more than we can handle. Got it?
Understood, Grandpa. It's time we were on our way.
Yes, it's better go to her at night. I've arranged a cart for us.
Do you have any Kupala salve left?
If I only knew, we could fly, but feet will do. And another thing, there's this rich fellow, Petrov is his name. He asked me to check on his field, says demons are ruining his crops. It's not far from Pintek, it so happens.
Well, Vasa, now I can say I've seen things. Cannon fire. A redoute, that's one thing. The devil himself, that's a whole different level. Still, I think that war is scarier. Much scarier than any chort. I still can't forget it.
You've seen too few chorts, Kolya.
Perhaps that's true, but that's beside the point. I'm not going to put up with it. I know how to get over this. I have an idea.
What are you thinking about?
I'm thinking of stepping right into the fire. If only something turned up.
You could die, you know.
No, no. I'm not talking about something like a campfire. And I'm not planning on dying either. It's not the devil I have to overcome. Man's greatest enemy is himself. That's what I think.
What happened down there, in the war?
Bah, Vasa. You wouldn't be interested. This war was thought up by the devil, and not other. Not by the Holy Spirit, that's for sure. I don't even want to remember. The thoughts alone make my hair white.
Is that why you started smoking?
Well, look at you. They don't call you knowers without reason. Well, yes. I'll start with something small, I think. To tell you the truth, I'm terrified even when I strike sparks with flint.